Welcome back to another video of the marathon. Yes, I watch my own videos in the background, trying to get that watch time up, trying to get monetized. But I told in the last vlog, I was talking about I had a meeting and I went well today. I didn't vlog it because I was in a rush over there, then drive to the airport. So I really didn't want to vlog and drive on over there. But basically how it went is me and him sat down, talked, and his previous content creator that he had, videographer, one that was producing content for him, wasn't doing his job, like not doing his job at all. So he got in contact with me because I shot a video for his son. We talked about it. He told me everything that he was looking for, what he wanted. And like I said, he's been in business at this facility for 15 years. He's run also multiple businesses, also trains a lot of entrepreneurs. So he knows what exactly he's doing and he knows the importance of content. And he was just like, if you like it, let's proceed to do business together. We'll talk numbers and all of that. And he agreed. So got his number, got his contact. I'm gonna be filming for him sometime this week. So y'all are gonna see it in this vlog. So I ordered one of the best wing spots in Atlanta, JJ's. And what makes them so good, I've had this like so many times since I've been out here, is your wings, they got crack wings. And I don't know what it is, they sprinkle some stuff on them and they're super good. And like, I tried it for the first time because I seen something about it. I think one of the barbers was telling me about it. It hooked ever since. Like that crack wings, it does it to you. Look at the box. Like, box is overstuffed. That's the crack wings. Like, all that white stuff over the top.
Uncle. Oh, that's wrong right there.
No, Uncle.
I am. Well, you can tell
him
right here.
What happened?
He has a girlfriend named Royalty.
What the fuck?
Yeah, they said they sent him back around. Yeah, back around. You don't know.
Okay.
Elijah, what's she look like? How you have a girlfriend in first grade?
No, he just told me. He was talking, then he gets quiet and he goes, Mommy, I have a girlfriend. I said, what?
Yeah, that's how it happened. Kitty, you remember you?
Why aren't you listening to school? Why aren't you listening to school?
I'm getting distracted because the hard's not work. Because the work is not hard enough.
Nigga, you just heard your mom say that.
How's your girlfriend?
She's 7.
She's 7?
No, 8.
What?
8
in the first grade?
Wait a
minute.
My pink HP.
Oh, the one you had from a long time ago?
Yeah.
Send me a laptop that you would like and I'll see what I can do.
Well, I don't know what laptop to get because I have to do chemistry lab stuff. I don't know which laptop's a good laptop.
Let me know like all the stuff you got to do because like you don't need nothing crazy.
All right, y'all. You can tell I sound a little bit under the weather. Your boy, things, these allergies is messing me up. Oh my gosh, bro. So let me update you guys about yesterday, right? I didn't vlog at all yesterday. See, I'm wearing 2 hoodies, 2 pairs of sweats, and 2 pairs of socks. Like, I don't take medicine at all. I just sweat this bitch out, right? Pretty much yesterday, woke up, went to the gym. And before that, I went to the gym, I had a phone call with a business owner, the one that I had a meeting with on Monday. And he wants me to come to shoot for his gym today just to see what I can do. And that's at 4:30. I had a call with JP. If you don't know, JP is one of the few music artists I shoot videos for. And so he wanted to talk about me going out there, shooting some content for him. He's been releasing new music. And then I got a call from Aaron, the trainer. Pretty much, he said, hey, you free October 3rd? I was like, yeah. And I'm not going to say too much about it, but just know, y'all just going to see it. I'm not going to speak on it. But when y'all see the vlog footage, y'all see the content from it, just know that shit's crazy. Oh, I finished all of the content that I had to do that from the reels I posted. Like, I was fighting demons. Like, kept telling myself, like, yo, shake back. Because, like, you can hear it in my voice. Like, I'm down and out. Like, you feel me? I'm leaned over, slumped over, saying, hey, yo, shake back, shake back, shake back. But shoot the content for them, come back, edit it for them, and see. Oh, I forgot, too. I got an opportunity to shoot. I'm going to be shooting for the University of Auburn, their baseball team, one of the players for the baseball team. So I think that's going to happen next week or in the next 2 weeks or whatever. That happened. I got that call when I was at the gym about it. So a lot of stuff is going on. I'm pretty excited for it. And, you know, this little sickness can't knock me down. I'm still going to be vlogging. I'm still going to be pushing out this content. Still going to be filming my own videos and things like that. But it's a grind. It's a marathon. You know, I'm not 100%, but I'm doing the best I can just so I can still perform, right? And I've been consistent. Like, that's the biggest thing. Consistency even on the days when you don't feel like doing it.
That's going on. And also too, while I was here, I got a call. It was crazy. Someone hit me up on Instagram, said, what's your number? I want to talk business. Gave them my number. We talked on the phone. They're like, yo, show me some work. I got a clothing brand I'm going to launch. It's me and my partner. We want to do it. What's your prices? Told him the prices. And then showed him the work. Then he was like, oh yeah, we want to work with you. We want a meeting tomorrow too. So I have a meeting tomorrow at 2. So a lot of stuff is moving fast. And you know, this shoot's going well. They want to continue to work with me and all that, and I'm excited for like the future to come. Like I said, this week's been going by pretty fast. Like yesterday I was super sick, then today I had 2 meetings and I closed them. So shout out to Allah for making this happen. And you know, it's just crazy. I just remember when I first started, I wasn't really getting booked. I was charging like gas money, $30 for videos. Now people are actually wanting to pay me bread, you know what I'm saying, just so I can shoot for them. So I'm grateful for it all.
Let's go.
All right, so I just finished filming. I'm in the office, get ready to go back home. But the shoot went well, and you know, I'm excited to see where this leads to, right? Like I said, he's been in business for 15 years, and basically what he wants is more, like a lot of people, just more people to see his business and more people to come to it. And that's where I come in. I showed him the work I did previous. If you've been following my Instagram, you've seen I did with Nick Edmonds. He was working at a smaller gym, was working for him. Then he moved to a bigger gym. Then I think by the time I moved to California, he owned like half the gym that he's currently at. And so I know what I can do with this content. So I'm excited to see what I can bring. He just wants to see what I can cook up, then we can talk and proceed from there. So I'm very excited about that.
Everybody works the way you need on the chicken, just for the first thing. I get in that kitchen, I cook all the work. I go berserk. Go out and get insecure, the city can't seem like the top. Crash dummy, girl, my target spending cash money. Smashing in a demon, still a smasher European. Gold digging, triple teller. He just got his first switch, let's take his money. Trying to put him on some damage, put him on a hit.
Alright y'all, so it is currently Monday and I didn't drop a video this week because like I said, I didn't feel like it was high quality enough for you guys, so I decided not to drop it. But right now I'm filming for Aaron and Omar. We're at this facility, this gym where they run a speed and agility class. It's my first time here, but let me show you guys what it looks like. Overall, it is it's a nice basketball gym. I see they have the Atlantic Dream banners around, so I don't know if they do work with the Atlantic Dream, but this is my first time here, and like I said, they're doing agility class with the kids, so I'm gonna capture that moment for them, as well as too. So when I go home, I'm gonna be filming a video for my Instagram / TikTok and step and edit that. Really, like, last week I was just off. Everything was just like off in terms of like, I didn't really want to film like myself when it came to filming or doing anything. This week, I feel better, I feel refreshed, and I'm gonna get back into it.
Give me three. Dude. Oh. I got that on camera.
You gonna go. Shot for shot. I ain't missing. You finna miss right here. Hell no. I don't miss. Camera on me? Camera? I don't miss. I don't miss.
He can't shoot like this though.
Oh!
I thought I don't miss. Okay. He about to miss right here. Yeah. Airball! I don't miss. Mellow ball.
Mellow ball.
So I just finished watching the Falcons-Eagles game right before I started working on my content I'm going to post this week. Good game. Shout out to Jesse Bates. I actually got an opportunity to film for him this offseason, and he made the game-winning pick. They're about to show it right now, but it's crazy seeing guys that you shot for this offseason and them making plays because, you, in a sense, you've seen the behind the scenes of what happened. So it's crazy because, shit, probably in the offseason they worked on this. Then just to see it happen in real life is OD.
48-yard attempt for an extra point, but he buries it. Philadelphia, they've got a timeout. And given the range of kickers these days, they don't need a ton of yardage, but there's Bates.
I seen he made the game-winning pick. Then I'm going to fix the audio output on my camera because, I don't know, for some reason, every time I talk, it's peaking, which is bad. That's probably throughout this video. That's why I like probably hear it like super loud and whatever you're listening on. So I'm going to fix that. Pretty happy with myself because the last few weeks I've been slacking, not waking up at 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning. And this morning I did, woke up, showered, began reading this book I was reading called Contagious by Jonah Berger. And, you know, I feel like when I wake up early, I get a lot of stuff done. And like the past few weeks, I haven't done that or actually taken the time to wake up and do it. So I'm actually pretty happy that I woke up. And let me show you this so you guys know I'm not capping. I haven't read this book in so long. So today is September 17th, right? The last time I read this book was August 28th. So it's been almost a whole month since I've been on my morning routine. And that's crazy. Like, I wouldn't say, well, yeah, I can say like a lot of my day-to-day has been knocked off because I don't wake up early. And you can see that today's the 17th. The last book I read, the last time I read this was the 28th. So almost a full month not pouring into myself and getting value to add to improve my craft and things of that nature. So that shit's just wild to me.
Change of plans today. I actually came to the fair because found out it was today. Literally found out on Instagram that it was today and decided to stop by. So currently here by myself and I just wanted to capture content. It's the first day. It's a lot of people coming out. There's two fairs in 2 weeks. There's another fair next week. That's the Georgia State Fair. I'm gonna slide to get content. Then there's also this fair is called North Georgia Fair or some shit like that. So I'm gonna get content for both days. And basically what I'm doing is I see this idea on Instagram where this dude basically was like taking my camera to the carnival, taking my camera to the
place. What's your YouTube channel?
LBC, LBC KEE. that one, the first one.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. So I'm just capturing content at the fair, seeing what I can cook up, all the lights, all that type of shit, just going crazy with it. I'm probably gonna be here for like an hour, hour and a half collecting content before I go back home. And the goal is I wanna drop this video by tomorrow, just so people can see it, people can come to the fair, shit like that. So I'm gonna go cook up a video, probably get some food, take a break, get some food so you guys can see it. So right now someone's going to do a human cannonball.
I'm going to vlog this.
He said basically he's
going to
go in like a cannonball, jump over this flying thing that swings this shit and land onto this raft. So I'm going to record that also too. I'm going to record this from the vlog. He's talking right now, talking to people about the stunt. But I really want to get this for the vlog and like talk you guys through it. So he's going to go in right now. They're setting up like the stunt and I don't know, shit's gonna be crazy, but that shit was pretty high when I was recording. Alright, good first day at the fair. Got some good content, gonna kick up a video that I'm gonna post to tomorrow. Real excited on how it's gonna go, right? It's like, it's crazy that like I found out about this today. Pulled up today just to shoot this, so I know that it's, I feel like it's gonna be a good turnout with the video. The reception is gonna be great, so I'm really excited about that. I'm finna head on my way back home right now. It's about an hour to get back to the house because this is pretty far from my house. So go home, edit this up, and I'm gonna show you guys what I cook up and post. But I don't know, it's just crazy. I found out about this shit today. Pulled up today, so it's gonna be. Bel Air House right now for its Revolt World weekend. If you don't know, Revolt World was owned by Diddy, but we're not with Diddy today, you know what I'm saying? So, but it's a Revolt World. A lot of celebrities gonna be here. It's the first day, so it's brunch going on. Like I said, every time we come to Bel Air, they always know when I come in the building, have the food ready, or else I'm not sliding.
Envy, you know, of course, we had the Revolt brunch. About to get things moving, but you know.
Hey, this nigga got signed to a 360.
Hell no.
Nigga signed his life away.
Hell no.
Nigga just signed his life away to Atlanta.
Hell no.
See, that's a lie. You can't say too much, bro.
We're just out here. Basically, whenever there's an event, Zoe just has a slide, get content or whatever. So I'm going to record everything, probably make a recap, get the vibe, get the interaction. We don't know what the vibe is. Hopefully, if you've seen like the last vlog before that, the Jim Jones shit was hell. That shit was like probably like the worst event I've probably been here. But this event should be better. The people here are more organized. So we're gonna see how it goes.
Vlog going crazy. Most random.
Random.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, you see, everyone vibes to that Kendrick.
You know what I'm saying?
Everyone vibes to that Kendrick.
Why everybody dropping that shit? Niggas being nice to you. You not recording, right?
Huh?
You not recording, right?
Of course.
Niggas.
Camera shy, usually don't do shit like this, but shout out to my boy LB out here doing this thing, man. Lock in with my boy.
Get the shoes!
Oh, yeah!
Shoes!
What's about those, man?
Oh, Spence Hodge USA, man. Follow it on the ground. Spence Hodge USA.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, the event is pretty much over. Good vibes, good shoots. Got great content. Finna cook up a recap for them so they can post it or the case may be. I'm actually might post it on my page because I never post on my page. But everyone's heading out right now to go to Revolt World right now. So, I think I might slide over there. I was supposed to go to the gym, but I don't know. We're going to see.
Hey, what?
This is the shit that my daddy had raised me on. Niggas got lit off the features I skated on. I gotta know how you get lit off the nigga you hating on. Numbers untouchable, they got the data wrong. This is the moment I know they been praying on. Tryna out a boy out, but fuck it, I'm staying on. Oh, keep on sending me slaps to go crazy on 40. Keep saying it's time to be patient. There's so many people, we turning the tables on. Capo got plans, but we'll say that for later on. Hush and keep saying they know that they played it.